equal to, might have been Don't Park on the Grass. So, yeah, I want to see how well he does here.
Yeah. Also, another great Pikachu in ESAM coming out of Florida as well.
Oh, yeah.
Bar none, best Pikachu in the game. So maybe the little bit of warm-up and practice you can get with the man who plays your character could be a little bit helpful.
Now, it is pretty funny because you don't see too many Pikachus, but the fact that they're playing each other is always a pretty funny concept. So Tachyon's ranked in Jax. I wonder if this guy, Nuna, is he ranked in Wisconsin?
Couldn't tell you. I do know Pow Pow is the number one player in Wisconsin, being a Sonic, and I couldn't tell you anything much other than that.
Gotcha.
Pretty even to start the game here. 4% separator, two competitors. That forwarder are going to make the gap a little bit wider as Tachyon starts to take pretty much the backseat role in this game as he's being edge guarded like nobody's business.
Yeah, I feel that as well. And right now we do have a Broken Alliance playing against Midwest American
Gaming.
Those are the two teams. And right now, I don't think that either player wants to take too much of a risk. I mean, they have the platform so they can sort of sneak a quick aerial from underneath. But when you have two of these players and two of these characters that can kind of grab one another and go for that up throw, down B, which is kind of like, it's a not guarantee, but you kind of have to read where they're going to go. But Pikachu's weight causes things like that to happen. Like, an up smash will kill it at 90%, which you don't see in a lot of other matchups. And considering how fast Pikachu's up smash is, it's a welcome strategy. Now, I'm just wondering just how much extra credit Tachyon's about to get. What is that hat he's wearing? I feel like I actually have never seen this costume before. It's like a Russian hat. Can't really tell. What I can tell is, though, the headband. No, I know Tachyon's is the headband, but... Yeah. The other guy has a headband. There's a Pokemon Gold hat. Okay, that makes sense. He is not relenting anymore. 30% going for one more edge guard. Quick attack into a fast aerial is a good way to confirm a kill.
All right.
The script, what do you think about this Ditto?
I just think that in the Ditto, because Pikachu is a character that can take a while to kill, especially on Battlefield having such a big blast on. So getting that first stock is super important. We've seen Tachyon kind of just really... like, lose his footing, it almost seems like. When it comes, or not lose his footing, I should say. I would say, losing his footing. But dropping his stock there, Tachyon.
I'm wondering if, oh my god, he went so deep! That was a gimp!
Okay.
He died at 3%!
Okay. Sometimes you gotta do it to your own character, man. That's what it is.
You gotta do him dirty. That was completely worth it. In a two-stock setting, you should always go for those.
Mm.
Tachyon sneaking. Actually, I'm getting confused again. No.
It's
BxA
tough, man.
Tachyon. No, like following who's who.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, because I see Tifa as a tag, and I see the T, and I think Tachyon.
Mm-hmm.
No. Tifa is Nuna from Wisconsin.
All right.
So
we got Freya now. Back to Battlefield.
He took game one, yeah. And he's running it back. He's like, you know, you got pretty dang lucky there. There'll be no problem for me. Yeah.
Some quick attack cancels, though, coming out at the beginning of this game. That fancy movement might prove a bit useful. Tachyon taking the first few blows of this game. With this little 10% lead in the first minute.
One immediate difference that I noticed in Pikachu from Melee and Smash 4 is definitely with this up air. His up air in Melee is designed to spike. And in this game, it seems like his up air is definitely designed to juggle over and over against every single character. That's what you want to get on those.
Yeah, you don't have those crazy, weird pseudo spike hitboxes in the back tail or anything like that.
Oh, but those gimps at 8%, man. You know I love watching
those. They'll get you. Ooh, that down smash, too, going to be beat out.
Only the first hit of it by trading for a side tilt.
Yeah. Both Pikachu's kind of just throwing caution to the wind here. Nothing too much rhyme or reason coming to it. Just trying to see who can get out on top of the scramble first. Again, still and down in percent. Those forward air, not safe on shield, but not going to be punished for it.
I believe there is a setting where, or a setup where Pikachu can do quick attack and then like do a jab reset and kind of just jab reset him across the stage into a forward smash if you like miss your tech.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Pikachu,
pretty cool jab lock.
Yeah, one of those characters that just has so many jab locks. Like lock off nair, you can lock off throws.
Yeah.
Yeah. Gotta be on your tech game, man.
When this game first came out, people were, you know, kind of saying Pikachu was arguably definitely top 10, arguably top 5. They really had him on top of the tier list very, very high. Before the age of the lovely DLC.
You gotta love it, man. Wait, I thought he came to me. Okay, I thought it was going to be another game, man.
Yeah. But
not today.
You know who we should have in Smash 4? We should have Abigail.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that'd be sick. That'd be sick.
If we have real design Abigail,
okay.
He'll be the size of the... That second platform on Battlefield.
Up there.
That's how big he'd be.
Got the tires on his biceps.
Oh, I would main him so quick.
I just want to see him like throw like Jigglypuff just across. Oh, yeah, I'm sure you don't, but
he can. he takes 2 steps per minute. I'd like him.
First, right,
first
kill.
Talk. Yep, going to Nuhuh. Mm. I'm sorry, going to. Let's screw this Ditto, man. Why are these costumes so similar?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
No big color change. With the forward smash across stage, not going to clear him out yet. Big battle, or Battlefield, proven to keep that stock on just a little bit longer.
Right.
Oh my goodness, the edge cancel. Pivotal there. Almost died.
It's annoying to Ditto your own character. It's really easy to get tilted because when you're losing to your own character, you're like, man.
Yeah, I just got outplayed.
This guy doing it better than I am.
Yeah. And it's just the thing of you have every tool that the other player has as well. So,
but when you lose like a Corrin or any other character, when you're losing, it's like, oh, it's like I can just John. That's the matchup.
Yeah.
But when it's a Ditto, you have no Johns. Like you're just getting outplayed.
Yeah.
Looking like we're gonna see game 3 though if Tachyon keeps up this pressure.
Yeah.
Tacking on little hits here and there on the shield.
Seems to be playing super safe with this lead he has as well. Oh my goodness! As I say that,
he almost lived too.
Yeah.
He was crouch catching, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah. Forward air on shield too, just falling right through the platform right after it as well. Skull bash off a dash attack.
Remember when we had customs and Pikachu skull bash?
Oh my god.
He died at like 20.
Yeah. I still trains into it.
I kind of wish you still had customs a little bit.
It's a bit too much of a scramble to keep control of.
Yeah.
But they're nice. They're a cool mix up.
Yeah. If the game had all the customs unlocked from day one, they would have literally been part of the tournament, part of the competitive play. And that would have been insane to see. But obviously, with that 1 month of customs that we had, you had things like Villager with his like camping and
Kirby was nuts.
Kirby was absolutely insane. DK's up B was just the strangest. Yeah. And then me Brawler's spinning jump kick.
Yep. Got like 20.
Yep.
Oh my goodness. Good,
wow, is that it?
At the edge here, too.
Oh!
Looks like Nuhuh's finding a little bit of life here. That nair off the ledge is going to get Tachyon some room.
Too bit of delay. Tachyon's saying, no, we got FL here.
We out.
We want to see Florida get game 3 really quick. But can he do it? Can he out rat the rat pack?
Yeah.
And dash attack barely not killing.
Yeah, getting kill sparks too, though. Two Thunderbolts finding to meet each other there, too.
Yes.
Oh, that nair going to beat him out of the quick attack.
And now we have my boy Nuhuh with full rage. Oh, be careful, Tachyon.
Yeah.
Don't do it to him.
Yeah.
Oh, no! Goodness! That's game!
Yeah, that's game, man.
That's game. Wisconsin crowd coming alive.
Yeah,
wow.
That max rage rat, man. That'll get you.
I believe that's a bit of an upset.
Yeah. Good stuff, though. Nuhuh putting on a little bit of a show there. That was cool. Defending his Midwest turf.
I definitely enjoyed watching it. So next up, we have, let's see.
Johnster. Oh, my
god. Johnster versus Cold Weather.
Now, let me tell you. Johnster. A former PR Michigan player, plays Lucario, and an absolute delight to watch. A tech fiend.
You know, so you know about this
guy.